Hey guys, Jobin here. I got some stuff to show you today. This is my new Vines pattern etching design, and I'm really happy with this one. I think the knives with it look really good, and personally it's a fun one for me to draw because each one can be a little more unique than a lot of the pattern styles that I do frequently. Because, you know, like you guys have seen me do lots of the flame or neuron pattern ones, and those are all unique because they're hand-drawn, but they look pretty similar to one another. Whereas these, you can just take a glance at them, and you can tell it's all the same style, but they're very unique. So let me give you some close-up views of these four, and you can let me know what you think. This is an EL01, like you've seen many times. And this one has my standard hand-rubbed finish on it. Let me zoom in a little bit. See how close we can get before the camera loses focus. That's not bad. All right, let's take a look at the other side. These ones look sort of tentacle-y. Is that a word? I don't know. It is now. Alright, that's the first one. And this guy here is one of my very, very few grayscaled EL01s. Only have a couple of these left, and I don't think they're in production anymore. At least they weren't last I knew, though I have been out of touch for a while. And on this one, I put the dark coating on it, which works really well with these scales because it matches almost perfectly and it really makes the vines pop. Although on this one I think they actually look kind of at least on this side they look kind of like lightning. I think let's zoom in a little bit. Yeah, there we go. Looking good. The other side. There's a big branch coming down there, splitting off. A little one up near the front. Little lizard logo there. I'm really happy with this one. And I wish I could get more with this scale color, because it looks great like this. Nice. Okay. Then we got a couple Ganzo G712. And you guys saw the one I ended up keeping for myself in some of my earlier videos, actually my comeback video. Here's a couple for you guys, for whoever wants them. These also have the gray coating on them, so you have that high contrast with the silver etch and the dark background. Zoom in a little bit again. Sort of straighter on this one with runners and this really curvy bit up here. I think this is a great blade design, a great knife for this etch, because you already have the curvy sort of dramatic looking blade, and then you put swooping lines on it in a design and everything just works together really well. All right, last but not least, I really like this one. Again, what I said about those sweeping shapes, I think it works really well here toward the end, particularly. That part's nice, though. I just really love how this whole side turned out, actually. Like I said before, that's one of the reasons I like this design, and I actually like drawing it. Is because you can do more variety. You can do different kinds of branches coming in from different directions, different numbers, different splits, but at the same time, you can keep the same overall style. You know, all four of these knives are recognizably from the same family, if you will, or all four of these etches. Alright guys, thank you very much for watching. As of the posting of this video, you might want to check the date. All four of these are available. If these particular ones are gone, maybe there'll be others like it up at that point. You'll have to go see. So check out my website. Link is in the description. Again, thank you for watching. Thank you for your business. This is Jobin signing off saying, remember where your knife is.